What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be showing you the best and most effective planche workout for beginners. Let's go. Video and start explaining the workout, I just want to let you know that I got three bonus tips for you waiting for you at the end of this video in addition to the planche workout. And make sure you subscribe and hit the bell notification below so whenever I upload a video you get a notification straight away. Let's start. So in my opinion the planche is one of the hardest static skills in the whole street workout, and the reason for that is because your whole weight of your body is held on this part, which is the shoulders, and the front shoulders are really really small. You have to start really really slow and be really careful with it since you're always on the verge of being injured. So if you're a beginner and you want to learn the planche, just keep in mind that it's gonna take a while until you get the good form of, let's say, straddle planche. If you want to see an example, I got a very bad form of full planche in 1 year. I'm gonna link the video somewhere in this corner. In that video you can really see what goes through every day and every second of planche training. For this beginner planche workout, we're gonna do 3 exercises. The first one is the L-sit to tuck planche swings. The second is assisted tuck planche. And the third one is the golden exercise, the planche lean. The reason I'm calling it the golden exercise is because this exercise works like magic. You can really do it anytime, no matter what level of planche you're in. So even if you have a full planche and you want to get stronger, you can do this exercise. So all of these 3 exercises are aimed at achieving the tuck planche. For the first exercise, the requirement is to have an L-sit. The L-sit is basically the most essential skill in all street workout. If you don't have an L-sit, you shouldn't even be thinking of training the planche because it really provides the base strength for all calisthenic skills. So in the first exercise, you're gonna do 3 sets of 3 reps of L-sit into tuck planche swings. So this is how you're gonna be doing this exercise. I'm gonna do 3 sets of 3 reps. Have to hold the tuck planche in each swing, but if you can do, go for it. I understand that most of you are beginners, so the tuck planche hold will be not required for this exercise, but by time when you get stronger, try to hold 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, and then going back to the L-sit. For the second exercise, we're gonna do assisted tuck planche, and by assisted I mean you get some help from the other part of your body. For this exercise, it's gonna be your knees. You're gonna place your knees against your elbows, which will in result push your elbows inwards. Since as a beginner myself, I was always struggling with keeping my arms straight, and as soon as I put more weight on myself, my arms tended to bend. So this will really help you push your biceps out and get used to keeping your arms straight. So this is how we're gonna do the assisted tuck planche, and I'm gonna do 3 sets of 3 reps. So you should be doing 80% of your strength in each hold and avoid going to failure, because I'll tell you the reasons in another video. So once we are done with that, we're gonna move on to our final exercise, the golden planche lean. For this exercise, we have to make sure that our biceps are facing outwards. You basically have to just remind yourself that your biceps should be facing the floor all the time. So always remind yourself that you have to turn your biceps inwards, outwards, as if your biceps are just looking forward onto the floor. So this is how we are gonna do the planche lean. Make sure your back is hollow and it's not retracted. I'm gonna be doing 3 sets of 3 reps, each rep with 80% of strength. By doing this twist, you really get used to the straight arm position, and by time you will not even have to think of keeping your arm straight or facing your biceps outwards. It will all automatically happen. So once you're done with this planche workout, your arms will probably be very, very tired, your biceps will feel really stretched, and your shoulders will be really fatigued. So I don't recommend training this every single day. As a beginner, you should be training, let's say, 2 or 3 times a week. Yeah, I think 3 times a week is pretty good. I really hope you enjoyed this planche workout. I have 3 bonus tips for you before we wrap up this video. The first tip is the hand placement. For me personally, I'm very used to planching on the floor. Don't get me wrong, I do use my dip bar for planche. I've tried parallettes, but on the floor it's way more comfortable for me. So experiment and see what works for you. Some people are more comfortable on parallettes. I think most people are more comfortable on parallettes than on the floor. So yeah. The second tip is to lose some weight. If you have any fat on your body, it's gonna affect your planche greatly, because every extra weight that's not working is a burden. Lose as much weight as you can. If it's fat, it's gonna be worth it. The progress will be so much faster. The third tip is to get enough sleep. I can't stress this enough. No matter how many times you hear it in every fitness video, they always tell you to get enough sleep for recovery. In the planche, it's most critical. It's the most important thing, because if you sleep 1 hour less than the usual time that it takes for your body to recover, you cannot train the planche on the next day. You will feel really exhausted. Even if you don't know about it, once you go and try the planche, you'll feel like your whole nervous system is shut down. Those are the 3 tips. I hope you benefit from at least one of them. And if you like more of these types of videos, or any type of video, or if you have any questions about this video, just comment down below. I'll take suggestions, I'll answer questions, and I'll hopefully make another video on explaining further into the planche, if any of you is interested. Peace out.